Hi, welcome to Device Tech Tip Channel. Today I'm going to show you how to set up your Apple ID using Gmail or any other existing email you have. If you bought your iPhone or iPad for the first time, you must be excited. You want to download free apps like TikTok or Instagram, but this is the screen you're stuck with. This is because you don't have an Apple ID set up yet. Without it, you won't be able to download any apps your friend has. So I'll show you the necessary step to set up your Apple ID. Typically, you end up signing up for an iCloud account. Instead of making another extra email account, I'm going to use Gmail as an example. Before you start that process, I want to remind you that you have to have good working Gmail and smartphone number. Good meaning you can check the message immediately because Apple will send you a verification message. And you still need smartphone phone number to get a verification code. Once you have those two, you're good to start. First, let's register your Gmail as an Apple ID. Go to your browser. Search Apple ID account page. Click this link. On this page, the Create Your Apple ID button is on the top right corner, or a little below on the page. Click the button, and you'll be sent to the next page. Enter your name. Region and your date of birth. Next, you can enter your existing email. In this case, I'll enter my Gmail and set a password. This is a different password from your Gmail account, preferably. Confirm your password again. After that, please register your phone number. Lastly, you have to pass through this CAPTCHA, which will prove that you are a real human. So you have to enter what's written on your left. If you can't read it, you can press the refresh button to get another CAPTCHA. Before you click on the Continue button, you can read the term and use of Apple ID and privacy here. I know you won't read it, and so am I. Coming back to the previous page and click Continue. Immediately after that, a pop-up will ask you to verify your Apple ID by checking your email. As you open your mail, you receive an email from Apple. Open this. The sender is Apple ID at id.apple.com and sounds genuine. In the content of the email, you see the 6-digit verification code. This code is one-time use only and expires in 3 hours. You go back to the previous screen and enter the numbers given. And click continue. Just to improve your security, don't let your browser save your password. So click never. Now, Apple ID will send you another 6-digit verification to your phone number. Enter it into the fill-in form. And click continue. Now you're finished registering your email. The next screen is the profile page of your Apple ID. It will display your registered information such as email address, date of birth, and phone number. I usually make a text document and write registered information and save it, because I will forget. Now the first step is complete. Next, we're registering your Apple ID into your iPhone or iPad. Go to your iPhone or iPad and tap on the setting icon. Tap on sign in to your iPhone or iPad button. A new pop-up will show and ask you to enter your registered Apple ID. Use your email address as ID and password you just set it up earlier. Now Apple ID will send you another 6-digit verification to your phone number. Apple does this two-factor authentication process so many times. Enter the numbers given. Now on top of all the Apple ID password and verification code, Apple asked me for a passcode to log in to my device. Please enter it. You don't have to merge iCloud. Click on name, phone number, email, and you can see the info on the next page. Finally, you can go to App Store and download free apps. When it displays Get right next to the apps icon, these are free. So tap it. Next, tap Install. You might be asked to enter your password, and this screen shows up. Require after 15 minutes or always require. Choose require after 15 minutes. If you don't choose this, you'll end up entering an Apple ID password every single time you download new app. Once downloading is complete, you see a new icon on your iPhone or iPad. That's the end. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more upcoming videos.